May be this one. I think that may very well be that one.
That makes a lot of sense.
It does.
Nietzsche scales the Nietzsche measure. The idea of assessing every one of your actions in terms of whether it's tilting your life in one direction towards the good or in another direction towards the bad. And I think Jerry and I have been pretty open, maybe even fast and loose about what good and bad is, trusting in a kind of intuitive sense of what makes an individual have greater integrity.
God and man played hide and go seek. God, go man, now man, don't you peek. Man counted to 10 and then looked around. God was nowhere, nowhere to be found. Man looked on the mountain, he looked across the sea.
You can't find me.
He looked in the stars, in the skies, in the trees.
Seek and you shall find, man.
He looked in the wind, in the sun, on the ground.
A foolish man.
But God was nowhere, nowhere to be found.
Hey, we've been looking all over for some information about Nietzsche. You're not very well advertised. How has it been going for you today?
Well, to be honest, it's been a little slow.
Uh-huh.
I haven't had any visitors. But, you know, it's still early in the day, and it takes people a while to kind of realize that you're here.
Do you think the location influences how many people you might have here?
I think this is a good spot, really.
Uh-huh.
To bring people in.
Uh-huh.
Near the edge.
Yeah.
Typically, people are just near the edge. I think to be near the edge.
I see. Well, I'm just wondering, I'm just looking around and I don't really see that many people. And
I know there's someone there. It'll just be a little matter of time before they drive over here, I think. They'll see me set up.
Well, you know, you could have set up over there, I guess, where the people are. But I guess this is another way of doing it.
Yeah. Well, this, you know, Nietzsche fans, Nietzsche scholars don't really like to be with the crowd.
I see.
They like to be by themselves.
Uh-huh.
But within sight of the crowd.
I see. But not right in the middle of the crowd.
No. We want to be seen by the crowd, but not,
you know. Uh-huh. Do you think the crowd over there can see you?
If they want to.
If they want to.
They can see me if they want to.
Yeah, but if you had a sign that said, if you're interested in Nietzsche, drive south, that, you know, just an idea.
That's only going to attract the wannabes.
The Nietzsche wannabes?
Yeah. No, I really only want the serious seekers.
Yeah, I see. How do you really know when you're talking to a wannabe, a Nietzsche wannabe?
Right, versus a serious seeker?
Yes, that would be the question.
It takes a little bit of kind of teasing it out of them to see how committed they are.
Uh-huh.
If they'll take a pamphlet, for example, or not,
uh-huh.
That's one indication of seriousness.
Uh-huh. So if I came over to you and said, you know, I take this landscape as kind of a great abyss, and when I look into it, it seems to be looking back at me, and I'm just wondering, would that give you the sense that I knew at least a little bit about Nietzsche and might be interested? Or is that still a sign of a wannabe?
I'd say, hello, brother.
Hello, brother. So is there a grip that goes with it? Is it a secret handshake, or is it pretty much just hello, brother?
Hello, brother. That'll do.
I see. Uh-huh. And then where do you go from there? So now I'm a brother, and I'm out here. Mm-hmm. I found you.
Mm-hmm. Well, then we pretty much go our separate ways, because you know that great Nietzsche saying that, you know, do you seek to multiply yourself by 10, by 100, by 1,000? Do you seek followers? Seek zeros. And, of course, the disappointed one speaks, the man who shouted and heard only an echo. Nietzscheans don't want followers. They don't want, you know, to
companions in that sense. It's a one-man job sort of philosophy.
Uh-huh. I see. Well, I'm keep looking over at the group of people, and they really don't seem to care. It's because I'm, kind of a wannabe, but mm-hmm. If I were going to want to make a presentation, how long do you plan to stay out here?
You are making a good point, because from where they're standing, if they were to look over here, they wouldn't have a lot of indication that I'm a Nietzsche table as opposed uh-huh. to, an Aristotle or whatever table. So I'm glad you mentioned that.
Yeah, I think that's good. I think that's going to help.
We're here so that then they can see.
So now the sign is in the other direction.
I'm not even. I should cut this a little bit.
Uh-huh.
Let's see what this table's all about. No one else is set up today. I'm surprised by that.
Let me just see.
Normally there's a couple of Navajo women here.
Uh-huh. And are they talking about Nietzsche as well?
No, they're selling jewelry.
Selling jewelry.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And
well,
a couple of times there's been a guy with literature on Hegel.
Well, I'm just wondering if you had some trade goods on your table, that maybe that would entice people to stop by, and then from there you could go into the Nietzsche.
For me, Nietzsche is not just a side business.
Uh-huh.
It's the main thing.
Right, but I mean just to as an attracting, just attract people.
Yeah, it's
just to pull them in, and you don't have any intention on selling them, it's just to draw them in.
Yeah, but if people aren't interested in Nietzsche, qua Nietzsche, I'm not really very interested.